Hi everyone, my name is Vijay Kumar and we are studying refrigeration and air conditioning. In the last video, we have studied about the thermoacoustic refrigeration system. Now in this video, we will study about vortex tube refrigeration system. Let's start. Construction of vortex tube refrigeration. It is one of the non-conventional type refrigerating system for the production of refrigeration. It consists of nozzle, this one is nozzle, diaphragm, this one is diaphragm, hot air side, this side is the hot air side, cold air side, this one is the cold air side. The nozzle are of converging type, diverging type, converging, diverging type. An efficient nozzle is designed to have higher velocity, greater mass flow rate and minimum inlet loss. This should be the criteria for design of efficient nozzle. Chamber is a portion of nozzle and allows the tangential entry of high velocity air stream into hot side. In this case, the compressed air will come from this side into the chamber of nozzle. There are so many nozzles, so it is a chamber of nozzles. The compressed air will enter into the hot side tangentially. Okay. Gradually the chambers are not of circular form, but they are gradually converted into spiral form. They are converted into spiral form. Hot side is cylindrical in cross section and is of different length as per design. It is of cylindrical shape, but is of different length. Here length is different, length is different. Valve obstruct the flow of air through hot side. This is a valve and this valve will obstruct the hot air flow. Hot air flow, this valve will be, the hot air flow will be obstructed by this valve. Diaphragm is a cylindrical piece of small thickness and having a small hole of specific diameter at the center. At the center, this is the diameter and this has a small diameter. Okay, so the air stream traveling through the core of the hot side is permitted through the diaphragm hole. Through the core, air stream will come like this and it will emit it through this diaphragm hole. Through this diaphragm hole, the air stream will emit it. Cold side is a cylindrical portion through which cold air is passed. This one is the cold air side and this one is the hot air side. So friend, this is the construction of vortex tube refrigeration. Let's see the working of refrigeration system. Compressed air is passed through the nozzle as shown in the figure here. Compressed air is passed through the nozzle. Here, air expands and acquires high velocity due to particular shape of nozzle. Because of shape of nozzle, it will acquire the high velocity. The air that rotates around an axis like a tornado is called a vortex. I have already told that it will spin like a tornado. Okay. A vortex tube creates cold air and hot air by forcing compressed air through a generation chamber. Through a generation chamber, the compressed air is passed through this vortex chamber. And in this chamber, it will convert it into hot air and cold air side, which spins the air at a high rate of speed, that is 10 lakh RPM into a vortex. The high speed air heats up as it spins along the inner wall of the tube towards the control valve. You see here, this is the air which is spinning or which is going like a vortex and like a tornado it is going. Due to this inner valves, this hot air will become very hot. Okay. Here the high speed air heats up as it spins along the inner wall of the tube towards the control valve. As this high speed will go towards the control valve, this will become very heat. So a percentage of the hot and high speed air is permitted to exit at the valve. At this valve, some amount of hot and high speed air is permitted to exit. So the remainder of the air stream is forced to counter flow up through the center of the high speed air stream in second vortex. There is a after exhaust of the air, there is second vortex will be created from the center of the valve. Second vortex is created. You see here a small vortex, and this has a velocity lesser velocity. That means the slower moving air gives up energy in the form of heat and becomes cooled. This air has moved in the towards the opposite direction of the high speed air. During the traveling in the opposite direction, the air which is going or traveling at the core or at the center in the opposite direction will give its heat to this heat, the high speed air. To the high speed air, it will give heat. So the inside counterflow vortex exits the opposite end as extremely cold air. So at the from this side, this air will exit extremely as a cold air. The gas emerging from the hot end can reach up to a temperature of 200 degrees Celsius, and gas emerging from the cold end can reach up to minus 50 degrees Celsius. The fraction of hot air exhausted can be varied to change the outlet cold air. If we are changing the exhaust air here, accordingly this cold air will change. Okay, the meaning of this, the fraction of hot air exhaust can be varied to change the outlet cold air temperature with more exhaust resulting in a colder air stream and less exhaust resulting in a warmer cold air stream and higher flow rate. This one has the lower flow rate. So friends, let's see the working of vortex tube refrigeration system. In this case, the compressed air is passed through the nozzle as shown in the figure. Here air expand and acquire high velocity due to particular shape of nozzle. Air that rotates around an axis like tornado is called vortex. Let's see the advantages of vortex tube refrigeration. It uses air as refrigerant, so there is no leakage problem. Vortex tube is simple in design and it avoids control system. There is no moving part in vortex tube, so maintenance issue is also not there. It is a light in weight and require less space. Initial cost is low and its working expense are also less. Where compressed air is readily available, that means where compressed air is available at that location, initial cost is low and working expenses are also low. Maintenance is simple and no skilled labor are required because there is no moving part in the system. What are the disadvantages of vortex tube refrigeration system? It has low COP, limited capacity, that means for limited capacity plant it can be used, and only a small portion of compressed air appearing as the cold air limit its wide use in the practice. The compressed air, that is the cold compressed air which is coming from the cold side, it has limited applications. Okay, this is the disadvantage. In this figure also you can easily see the compressed air is coming here, and like a vortex it will flow, and through the inner wall it is getting heat. This air is getting heat and it is at very high speed, and some amount of hot air will be emitted or exhausted from outside through the hot side chamber, and through this wall some amount of air is sent back, and it is at lower speed. As this lower speed will flow in the opposite direction, and this lower speed air will also flow in a vortex. As this air will flow in opposite direction, this will give its heat to this air which is going in the hot side. So this air is a very cold air. In this diagram you can also see how it is working. So friends, in this video we have studied about the vortex tube refrigeration system. Thanks for watching this video and have a good day.